You don't get the Elegy of Emptiness. I've actually died to that mine before. Just like finished the sunblock clip with a half a heart, dive back in and instantly hit a mine. Feels the worst. Luckily their heart's right here so I can get them. I'm actually afraid of dying because I want to save my fairy for Twin Mold. Because Twin Mold is completely RNG. Basically we don't get the mirror shield, so we can't do this room. So we have to glitch our way through with Weird Shot.
Too bad. The mirror shield is so awesome.
Yeah.
This room is really laggy, so doing Weird Shot is difficult.
Yeah, it is still pause buffering, but you have to get a feel for what the game's frame rate is at the moment.
Also, the room's lag is very dependent on how fast you can pause buffer, because the more lag there is, the longer it'll take to, the longer you have to wait before pausing to buffer forward. And for safety strats here, normally I wouldn't go up to full bombs, because this is way more than I need, but I'm gonna do it anyway, just because.
What are these critters called again?
These are called Gojirons. Right. They're basically fake Gorons.
I'm sure that's some kind of, like, clever wordplay in Japanese.
Probably, yeah.
Ron, it's Gojira.
These Gojirons.
I think I saw a news article title somewhere that said, Japan thinks the new Godzilla needs to lose weight.
He's not kawaii enough.
So here we do another weird shot to hit, get to
right
this
into
chest.
Fire.
Ugh. So.
360 spin master.
The Great Spin Master. So,
here's my favorite character from this game. The
Garo
Master
is weak to ice arrows, but because we don't have ice arrows, fire arrows are just as good. Now, the thing is, he's kind of retarded, so if we just aim at him, he'll disappear, and then instead of landing on us to attack us, he'll land directly in front of us. Which is... Whoa. Basically, what I'm doing... Whoa, how did I miss that? Basically what I'm... Oh god, that's so close. What I'm doing here is I'm rolling, and at the end of my roll, I'm trying to get hit by his sword, so that he'll, he'll just basically won't deal me damage with it. But it kind of failed. Like that. And then I just hit him in his face, because he's like, yeah, I gotcha! And I'm like, no.
This is the other thing I like about Majora's Mask, because the combat is actually, like, fun and engaging. Especially compared to Ocarina of Time, where it's kind of like...
You might actually be
items.
On top of the chest here.
Yeah, in Ocarina of Time, the only thing that was like vaguely interesting combat-wise was the pirates.
Oh,
but
that's pretty
even scary. That was like...
Yeah, the Gyarados.
Yeah.
If you bonk off chests but keep mashing your A button, you can open the chest no matter where you're standing in front of it. As long as you're facing it. Okay, so now that we have light arrows, we're going to equip those because those are too good. And sword of the entrance. We're done with the temple now. We have to flip it because the boss room is in the inverted stone tower temple. Luckily, playing the Song of Soaring inside temples still says, do you want to go to the entrance? And doesn't try and warp you anywhere weird. Because when you're in temples, it doesn't check for owls.
Right.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So, do you have to flip the temple to get to the boss?
Yes.
Yeah, actually, like, the boss room is not
the loading zone of the boss room is in the inverted temple. Basically... The inverted version of... Oh, God.
It's like another temple.
The inverted version of the room where I just fought Garo Master, that hole in the ceiling is the hole I need to jump into to get to the boss fight.
But, like, is the loading zone for the boss there?
Yes.
In the regular temple?
No, it's only in the inverted
okay,
temple.
Okay, yeah. So the inverted temple's, like, a different map?
Can't, like,
yes.
It's a separate map. It's probably
you can't
not...
bomb hover up
yeah,
to
that's
it.
Yeah,
probably
not.
Can't.
It isn't actually...
It's,
just
there's a, nothing there.
It isn't actually run through a projection matrix to invert it or anything like that.
Yeah, I mean, it probably for this and for the actual temple, they probably just made two versions of it.
Yeah.
I mean, it sounds practical on paper, but it would just be a programming nightmare for the sake
of. Oh, yeah,
of
totally.
The game.
They just flip all their textures, like, by hand, I'm sure.
Yeah.
This is still really, really cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this is where we do this. Now, the faster way to skip the boss key is through the left side of the temple, but it's also very high skill because I have to hover very carefully over the top of some void zones And if I fail to get them, then I just don't have enough bombs to complete the thing. So I'm going to do the right side of the temple, which takes a little bit longer, but it's also quite fast, and it's much safer. I also haven't learned to do the other way properly, because basically it's super hard unless you know how to mega flip, in which case, like, doing it is easier, but, like, mega flipping itself is really hard. For those of you guys who don't know, mega flipping is basically, if you do a roll, and then a backflip onto the explosion of a bomb, it sends you rocketing backwards. It's basically hovering 201, but it's just too much. So we're gonna come over here because I need full arrows, and preferably full magic.
What's the number to let people in?
There's
only
one
button.
So, one. So this Dexy hand, if we're too close, well, oh fuck.
Or that happens.
Basically what you do is you come down here, and it's just a way to collect those rupees, but we don't care about Dexy hands, so we're just gonna blow them up. We have to do a perfect recoil flip to make
Dexy hand doesn't care about you either.
I only recently learned how to do that, just like a week ago. Basically, I was tired of failing recoil flips, so I took 20 bombs to Hyrule Field and just recoil flipped, and I've never failed that since. Practice makes perfect.
Yeah, practice makes perfect.
Okay, this is the boss key skip, and this is really hard, because I need to not only get a perfect recoil flip, but I also need to hover up to a chest that's on the ceiling, and I need to stand on top of it.
No big deal.
And I have tons of bomb chews here, so basically this trick is determinant on how many bomb chews you have. Still have ISG. I always check just to make sure, because that saves a bomb chew in case I fail.
If your sword leaves a motion trail, that means Infinite Sword Glitch is still active.
Basically, whenever you lock something with your Z button, or when you Z target something, you're able to change directions in midair. So I'm breaking my target, then I'm changing directions to get where I want to on this chest. And I'm just getting to the very edge.
Now the real trick is to open this chest with your feet.
You can do that.
Really?
Yes, you can open upside down chests. It's how 100% does it.
Oh.
That was good. That was perfect. So now I'm in the unloaded boss room. And it's still there, and the loading zone's still here, so I just jump into the center of the room and enter. So, I still have my fairy, which is good. This boss fight is completely random. The worms both go completely just in a random pattern around the room. And because I don't have the giant's mask, because the Kokiri sword is really weak, well, I guess the hero sword is really weak, I have to kill him with arrows. Fire and ice arrows deal 3x damage to the worm of the opposite color, and light arrows deal 2x damage. So I have enough fire arrows, and basically what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to deal the maximum damage I can to one worm, kill it, or without killing it, and then kill one worm. Because when there's only one worm, the other one moves at twice the speed. So I just want to hit the fast worm with one instead of a bunch.
Now this takes like some actual impressive archery, because you have to lead your shots. They have a certain speed, it's not just hit scan. You have to hit their tails. And this also costs magic. So you have to like really pick your targets here.
Also, if I run out of arrows, that's devastating. Because I have to go out there into the desert and hope that one of those bricks out there drops arrows.
And the worms have to break it for you?
Yes.
Ugh.
I have to wait for the worm to go in.
I think normally you can break them if you're a giant mask mode.
As Giant Link, you can get giant and break them. But I don't have the giant's mask. On this TV, the brightness is making it hard to hit with the fire.
Oh,
cuts.
Wow, yeah.
Okay, so I think that was three hits.
Blue.
Why
did
they never turn the contrast down?
Because I'm fine with this. It's just the sandstorm going on.
Desert troll.
Very much.
What happens if you look at that one instead?
What happens if I what?
Would it help if you looked at the other TV instead?
No, that's probably too much lag.
Yeah.
No. Okay, so basically now I have to kill the red one. Yes. The blue one is the blue. Basically, okay. They take three arrows of the opposite color to kill, followed by. Oh my god.
Oh god, he totally fucking cock-blocked you.
Maximum trolling.
He cock-blocked you so hard.
These worms are the biggest fucking trolls in the world, I swear. Also, Rhett, skip light arrow skip, or skip light arrow split. I forgot to tell you to split there.
Oh, right.
Fucking worms. This is my least favorite part of
the
story.
Oh, I went the wrong way.
Dude, Rhett, you have to play Sandstorm. Play Sandstorm right. on
Please
screen.
Don't play Sandstorm.
Not even during. Oh, we're gonna skip the cutscene actually. We got storage.
Yeah. Oh my fucking god! I'm in a clusterfuck of worms here.
This boss fight is a highlight.
Wormstorm.
This is the shittiest RNG I've ever gotten. Where they didn't attack me.
Ugh. We're seeing Smo do this sometimes, where Smo swinging his big hammer around can move Ornstein out of the way of your attacks. It doesn't hurt Ornstein, but it just shoves him around. You can miss with moves when you're trying to hit him.
Watch all 3 days go by before he finishes the boss fight.
No, I would run out of arrows long before that.
Nice.
That was too
hard. Too greedy.
I don't want to hit the blue one either, because if I do, then this battle just got a lot harder.
Yeah, when one worm dies, the other one starts going faster.
Oh my god!
Okay, so 9 arrows. I haven't kept... Oh my god. I haven't kept track of how many arrows I've hit the red one with, because
it never occurred to them to do that before.
What if we actually hit
no,
the stupid kid?
Out,
stupid kid shooting arrows at us.
There.
Seriously,
okay.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Did you see like all the trolling, or are you making the same rage?
What?
Did you see all the trolling?
Did
okay.
you fucking see
oh, that
the
was so much
every
trolling.
Time it was like perfect shot lined up, and then the other one
the
would go,
hey
guys,
going
what's up?
Like, Matt's
and
actually
the
looking
the
good.
Head has perfect armor, so it's just like,
Matt's
nope.
like lining up this shot like for like 10 seconds, like tracing the tail, like getting
and it was
the
perfect too.
And then the other worm just like bursts right in front of the tail, like right as he's ready.
Just like
to
comes
shot.
Right in the
this
frame,
is,
like out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Hey guys, what's going on? Oh, goddammit.
She like completely photo bombs.
Nobody fucking likes you, man. Fuck off.
Oh yeah.
Nice.
There you
nice.
Go.
Yeah, killing that's twin good. Mold with arrows definitely takes some practice, because, like, you have to be ahead of him. You have to take into account the time it will take for the arrow to travel to him.
Yeah, it's lucky that he has a long stretch though, so you can look and say, okay, that's where he's gonna be. Now I just have to figure out how long. Like, you don't really have to estimate where he's gonna
split.
Be, just when.
So now I only have left is Majora's Mask and a 5-minute long cutscene.
Nice.
So it's split, should say, Majora's ass.
It's just like a giant butt?
No, there's no giant butt.
Aww. Oh, no.
Majora-
I wanted there to be a giant butt on the moon.
Case.
I was trying to fix the splits and I accidentally broke them, I'm sorry.
That's fine. I know what time I was at now, and I'm, like, way behind PB. I'll still get, like, probably sub 215, which is disappointing.
Yeah.
Considering
oh, yeah.
how many times I had to redo Snowhead.
It was, like, 203.
So instead of collecting the silver rupee and getting bombs to hover where I want, I'm actually coming out here, because you can find bomb drops on the field, and also I need a Deku stick, because I need the Stick of Truth to defeat Majora's Mask. So now we have to pray that I get a bomb drop from these bushes. And if I don't, well, there's a lot of bushes on Hyrule, on Termina Field. Okay. Nice quick spins, bro.
No scope.
Okay, on to the next one. We're doing this until I get bombs.
Why don't you just dupe over your bomb bag and then buy another bomb bag which has 20 bombs inside of it.
I'm gonna kill the rest of these bushes while I'm here.
Or
chill.
Okay, I can do this with 5 bombs.
Why don't you just buy a powder keg?
Defeat Majora. Defeat Majora with a powder keg.
No, just buy a powder keg, period.
I do not have the proper paperwork to own such a weapon of mass destruction.
There's gotta be some, like, stupid, like, glitchy way to obtain, like, infinite powder kegs or something.
That would be amazing.
This is Frank Rizzi, and we need him to complete the run.
Yeah. I need to use this dog to get ISG, basically.
Everybody, Frank Rizzi.
And then he also breaks my target, so...
So he does something on, like,
so
the
Frank,
games.
Yeah.
Now I need to turn around and hover.
It's weird
into
how
the clock tower.
That effect. Just like how, well, before the clip was discovered, it was like, oh, Navi Dive. Navi is actually good for something.
So they didn't put a ceiling on Clock Tower, so I can hover over top of the door and enter here without having to wait till midnight of the final day.
It keeps the day-night cycle going.
Yes, it's still day, even though the moon is clearly right there.
It'd be weird if it orbited, though.
So it's like not even
going to
hit Clock Tower anymore.
Yes. Oh, cool. So all you have to do is just find your way to the Clock Tower during the day. And
by the way, the moon is just way up there, you know.
Yeah.
It's just going to land somewhere in the ocean.
Yeah.
That's it, done.
Even better, we'll just miss Earth.
Why is your thing so red?
Oh, I use a flux, which is
that?
Blue light is like bad for your eyes late at night.
Mm.
So it like detects what time it is and where the sun is.
So this is
and, like,
where
dims your screen.
I would go for
That's
a
cool.
bathroom
so
break
it
or make something to eat.
Yeah, it filters out the blues basically.
What's this?
Oh, just a thing I use
Cuts
on my.
I'm going to get some food. See you guys later.
On my computer.
See
my
you
phone
guys.
Too. It's really good if you're like
Wait,
up
you
late at night.
Things.
On your computer
not
for like a long time.
But
it's
Matt,
good for your eyes.
Miss
is it on your computer as well?
yeah. I have my computer
before.
On the phone.
Okay.
It's just blue
Yo,
light.
Check
like
me out. I'm so good at this game.
There's like some research that seems like blue light like is more likely to keep you
like,
awake longer,
okay.
like late at night. You kind of like
yeah.
turns
yeah.
your brain on sort of
it's
more, so it makes you kind of sleep a little better.
Obviously,
if you filter it out a bit.
That's interesting.
A 10-person single segment run. Yeah, go.
Shoutouts to Chinese food.
Hooray, Chinese food.
Hooray.
Base salt and pepper
is that squid.
Uh huh.
Cool.
Salt and pepper squid from Fairway. Not bad.
Oh, you guys went all the way to there?
No.
Solid.
I also got poutine. Maximum over fat.
Also, those nuggets, which are like literally 25% fat.
Check out the stats on this nugget.
Like literally 25%
fat. Drop your nuggets.
How does you get 25%
toss your nuggets
into a single nugget?
I need this as a custom emote when I become subscriber. Raise
your nuggets.
It's just a picture of that like breaded eldritch abomination.
Have you cooked them yet?
Uh-uh.
You don't cook them so much as absorb them.
Is this a stack on plate?
Apparently. Well, that, like, they don't quite even touch the moon.
I love this, yeah. They touch the force field around the moon.
Yeah.
So when it stops, they're just not even touching anything.
They do the praise.
Yeah.
Yep.
Praise
much.
Be unto him.
No.
And do the jiggy with.
Oh, it's pineapple sausage. Yeah.
Give us
I was
that.
Pineapple sage.
They're all giving Link that fine crotch shot.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
They're just, like, touching the atmosphere of the moon. They're not actually.
Dude, Skull Kid always jealous of Link. Noticed he was speedrunning the game, so he decided to export.
Praise
his
it!
Own
praise the moon.
Hallelujah! Oh God!
Praise
so bad.
I love that.
I love his beard. And that guy's beard was amazing. Or his little.
430. Praise it.
I love how the face isn't aiming down for that one segment.
Yeah. He's just like, whip back. And the giants
now
are just like completely stuck.
You get to go up the moon's nose.
Yeah. It's like reverse booger.
Actually, we go in its mouth.
Close enough.
Spider.
Your nose and mouth are pretty well connected, you know?
So, this is just story, basically. Like, yay, we're together. The Skull Kid was so bad, but he didn't know what he was doing. He was just, like, causing trouble. What? You saw what he did. And then, basically, the mask is like, actually, it was me.
Yeah.
And now I'm gonna kill everything.
Would've been awesome, like, the mask goes on the moon. And then the moon just, like, starts...
being a dick.
Yeah!
Anyone else
brings down
that?
Like the solar system.
Has anyone seen that video where it's just like the moon up in the sky? Like, wait, you want me to hold this face for 3 days? What the hell, man? No, let me do something more like this. It does the troll face.
Yeah.
I've seen the one where they've replaced his mouth with like the colon D, like happy face. Just like, ah!
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
It's awesome.
What needs to happen at.
Basically, this
at
mask.
Victoria Marathon 2 is you need to get the Nicolas Cage texture replacement mod.
Yeah.
Where they replace all textures with Nicolas Cage's face.
Let's just have a ROM hack themed marathon. We'll get.
Yeah.
We'll get Dragon MZ back out to run a.
Basically, the moon
not
is.
A Super
the
Metroid
mask
ROM
is like, fuck this, I'm going to the moon. And then he's like, well, I'm going to make the moon more powerful, and then just the moon starts overcoming the giants. And now we have to jump inside the moonbeam.
So, they're giving it more gravity then? Question mark?
You know, if they just dropped it at this point, it actually wouldn't, like, really do that much damage.
Majora's mask is, in fact, such a badass, he just stands on the moon and suddenly makes a breaking. I don't know if I can handle this, guys.
Oh, it's just a moon. Oh god, it's a mask and a moon. Oh!
Yo, that mask is the camel breaker.
Yeah.
Alright. To the moon!
Yeah, throwing a kid up there doesn't even help you that much.
It's
bam!
Just
zoom!
A tree.
Straight
just
to the moon!
So the moon's just a giant field.
For some reason.
Oh, with your last bomb.
Nice.
Yeah, you're supposed to only have one bomb there.
Yeah, we just need to wait for him to forget to stop and just keep going to the other side of the
Oh, I should sleep.
The other kids are greedy fucks.
Yeah.
This is the only one we want to play with.
Fight me, kid.
So, now we need Zora mask, because that's too good.
Turn in your bottle mask.
Keys, and we need the stick.
Turn in the bottle mask.
Just put the bottle on your head.
Dude, that's not safe for children. I don't endorse that. That's a safety hazard.
Alaska, break.
Put this over your head, little kid.
Who needs a Zora mask when you have a fishbowl?
Yeah.
So I'm dumb and broke the timer again. Anybody know when we started? We started at like 11:30, didn't we?
I don't remember.
This run?
I don't know.
Somewhere around there.
You
nobody
have
no,
all
I actually checked, obviously.
No, I have two masks.
Well, you had a third mask.
I had a third mask, but it turned into a bottle.
I actually have no idea what our time is anymore. I was kind of dumb and just like reset the timer again.
So basically, the back of Zoralink's fins can hit Majora's mask. It's the easiest way to hit him. And the reason I'm not Z-targeting and hitting him with the fire arrows is because it's completely possible for the fire arrows to go through the mask. And there's nothing I can do about it.
Unless you don't Z-target.
Yes. Well, sometimes they do if I'm too close and I don't Z-target as well, so.
It's weird.
So, it's just, it seems to be random, but if I don't Z-target, then it's okay.
I know this is the final battle of the game.
So
we're coming up to 140.
Yeah.
We're actually back on schedule almost.
So you
beat your estimate by quite a bit.
I think
you're actually around 220.
So basically the remains masks all fire these large energy balls at me and they deal 1 heart of damage each. And at first I thought, well, it's Marathon, it would probably be safe to kill them, but it's actually safer to just completely ignore them and hope they don't hit me. Because the longer this segment of the fight goes, the more chance I have of dying, and I really don't want
to
die. Because Majora's incarnation just kind of trolls me, like, this entire time, just dancing around, and I'm just kind of sitting here trying to dodge these things. So I have the crouch stab of my stick on, oh god, get closer. Oh,
this guy
really
literally
good.
Is a troll hipster, like he was doing it before troll face.
Get over here! Fuck! Oh, for some reason I hit him. Good.
Nice.
This is actually a really fast segment. So my crouch stab is just too powerful, so Majora's Wrath just dies.
That's awesome.
Or Majora's Incarnation. Now I have to fight Majora's Wrath, and
Majora's awesome texture.
The remains mask is blocking the cutscene.
Well, the final boss is actually
It's actually the remains mask.
Skyborg, round two.
If I time an arrow there, I can. Oh god, if I time an arrow there, I can stop his. There we go.
Like what happens when
go.
I got him in a stun lock.
Oh,
the remains mask.
That's
kill that fucker.
Gyorg is pissed, man. He wanted to be in that shot.
If you use the light arrows, though, Majora's Wrath won't dodge your attack at all.
Time. That full reminds me of the.
Let's see, that's my final time.
It's actually less. I think you actually got around 220.
Yeah.
We are 40 minutes behind.
Okay.
But now we're back on time.
With all the shitty mistakes I made in this run, 2:20, if that was my time, that's only like 10 minutes off my PB. So there's a lot of room for improvement. But, yeah. Majora's Mask in 2 hours.
I'm sorry for breaking the timer, but we can meticulously analyze it in the archives to get a more accurate time if anybody really cares.
The last thing I was describing is that you have to time an arrow so that when Majora's Wrath goes to attack you, he can't dodge because he's stuck in the animation. So you can just stun him with the arrow. But if you have light arrows on, he won't dodge the light arrows. So even if you're out of magic, you can still fire a light arrow without magic, which is just a regular arrow, and he still won't try and dodge it.
Oh, I'm gonna
and
turn
so
the
it's just an easy,
here.
Just you just straight shoot him.
So I was gonna figure out how to
that
put
is the
a PC
worst lag I've
screen.
Ever seen on this cutscene right here.
Huh. You can work on that while we're watching the credits, I guess.
Alright, who wants to mention what's next?
I guess Nathan's
Well, don't you have to use that?
It's kind of.
Yeah, I have to use that computer, but it's
so much out of
the
fucking
edge. But when, aren't the splits also on that computer?
One last thing. I play this game on an N64 controller hooked up to a GameCube to N64 adapter. Because C buttons are too good. And I can't handle the stick.
C buttons are top tier.
They're the toppest of tiers.
But we are like kind of getting it up, so. You can just like report your time.
The first one,
I guess.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Honestly, I can just lend you my copy if you want to try it out.
Beside me, for example, you can just hit the splits.
So, I should be able to manage for half an hour or so.